Ladies and gentlemen, we are on the slow road, but the road we are on nonetheless to the end of Universe Mode. As we're on episode 39, one episode away from High Stakes, the main roster pay-per-view, and we are slowly building up to NXT TakeOver 59 and the road to the Royal Rumble. Now, with that said, if you're wondering about ratings, NXT, if you're gonna help NXT tie Raw's ratings, you need to get this video up to 63 views. Is it possible? I don't know, because NXT's never won in the ratings war. But they have an opportunity if fans put forth enough support into it. We'll see, though. Regardless, we're going to hop into the show. The show opens up with Arthur Rex, the WWE's new NXT champion, and he states that he watched NXT TakeOver back and saw what happened. Jey Uso interfered in the match. This, to him, taints the start of his reign. He feels, in his heart, he could win that match, and he's proud to be the NXT champion. But that's why he took the challenge of Wilkens for tonight. He feels he must prove himself to the fans and to the roster that he's deserving of calling himself the NXT champion. So tonight he's going to focus on Jackson Wilkens. The man may not have a title, but he's dangerous and unpredictable. Rex wishes Wilkens the best of luck, but then he's interrupted by the returning David Perez, who has a microphone in hand and says that his suspension is lifted. And he's not going to wait in line. No. There's one title he wants, and that's the NXT Championship. He's interrupted as well by a taped up, bruised, and battered Tony Ramirez. This man tells Perez that it's good to have ambition, but to expect the champion to accept a suspended wrestler's challenge is ludicrous. He's interrupted as well by TJ Bauman, who has a microphone as well, and states that Ramirez shouldn't be talking when he got beat at NXT TakeOver. Bauman is the only legitimate challenger for the NXT title, and it's time for him to... Leon Barnett comes out onto the stage. Everyone's kind of spread out at this point around the ring. And he says that he is the only legitimate person to have an opportunity. He is the winner of the King of the Ring tournament and is the true number one contender. That is a fact. So it's time to shut everyone up. At TakeOver 59, he's using his number one contendership opportunity. It's official. Now everyone can get behind him. The line starts over his shoulder. He tells Rex to keep the title warm for him because it's high time that the Slayer of Jamie gets his due and his gold. Following this, David Perez goes to the back and runs into the rest of high society. Angel embraces him, and he proceeds to tell West and Mr. Expendable that they need to step up tonight. It's time for a rebound. He leaves and everything falls apart. It's time they march to getting back their titles. All of them. Angel agrees with his words and says that she vows to regain the women's championship, whatever it takes. Perez asks West and Expendable if they can beat Creighton and Madison tonight, and West frowns at this. He replies that Perez needs to shut his mouth and let them work before he and Expendable head to the ring. So we do have an opening bout. It is Creighton and Madison versus High Society in the Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic. After a hard-fought back-and-forth war of attrition between the two teams, Creighton and Madison get the win. Therefore, they will advance in the tournament, which is great news for them. Good for them. Either way, they are the third team to advance. They will face the Ambassadors of Violence, which are the NXT champion, and the NXT North American champion. A huge opportunity for them. Either way, West and Expendable head to the back where Perez asked, what happened? Did they not want to win the tag team titles back? Did they get soft in his time away? West grabs Perez and said that none of this would have happened if he didn't get suspended. Perez deflects this and says that it's on them for losing the tag team titles, though. If they don't find a way to get them back, then maybe, just maybe, Both of them are, for lack of a better term, expendable. Angel steps in between them before anything else is said and tells West to go cool off. Tensions are too high. If they want to rebound, it starts with everyone being level-headed. West and Expendable leave after a bit of hesitation, and then Angel proceeds to slap Perez across the face and tells him to stop instigating and creating conflict. Now is the time to get back up, rather than to tear each other down. Wise words from a villainess. After this, TJ Bauman is interviewed and asked about his upcoming match with Dar tonight, but Bauman laughs and says that it's going to be a cakewalk. He wasn't even concerned about it, especially when he walked out to the ring tonight. Now, he's beaten some of the biggest names in NXT, and he's already beaten Dar before. He considers this match a warm-up for the big one next NXT. From what he hears in the locker room, Mr. Samuel, the GM of NXT, is debating on announcing an NXT number one contendership match for next show. So for now, he'll use Dar as a human pin cushion. He might be part of the dynasty, but he's not as intimidating or as good as the others in the group. He's not underestimating him either. Dar, on his best day, just can't lace up the real wrestling machine of NXT's boots. Sounds like underestimating to me, but call me crazy, I guess. Creed and Madison are then interviewed about their victory as a team. Madison says that this feels like one last push for him to get some more gold, and he's happy that Creed answered the call for aid. He's appreciative, but also dead set on this tournament. He understands that Creed has that match with Jamie at NXT TakeOver, but he wants to make sure Creed puts the team first as well. Creed says he does, and the two shake hands. Creed is then asked about the match with Jamie, and he said he's nervous. He admits that there are nerves there. He's no longer teaming with a three-time world champion, but facing him. He feels that this is the biggest match of his career on paper, and he has to win to step forward. Getting the win with Madison regained his confidence, and now it's time to deliver his best if he wants to beat one of the best. Just then, Mr. Samuel comes up to the pair and congratulates them on their victory. He then asks them how they'd feel about a little bit of a side quest. Both of them are confused, and he offers out his hand and says he'd like to do them a favor and ask them in public to give them a little bit of a spotlight. Do they want to join the roster for the Royal Rumble match? Both are shocked, but ultimately shake his hand and accept the offer. Mr. Samuel thanks them and wishes them the best of luck at the Royal Rumble before leaving the pair to celebrate. So, those two will be in the Royal Rumble match. Builds up a lot of hype. But ladies and gentlemen, we go to the ring again for TJ Bauman versus Noam Dar, which is a hard-fought battle that in the end, Noam Dar manages to dodge TJ Bauman, who slams himself into the turnbuckle that he exposed. And Noam Dar rolls him up for the 1-2-3 to get the win. Bauman then hops up and starts beating down Noam Dar before any celebration can really get underway. Just then, Johnny Rivers from SmackDown, the Cruiserweight Champion, dives into the ring and starts brawling with Bauman, who ultimately bails out of the ring. Bauman backs off and says that this is beneath him. He's out of here and leaves. Rivers leaves the ring and nods to Dar, who's glaring at him. Rivers gets the back, and Mr. Samuel asks him if Class Park put him up to showing up here. Rivers states that he wasn't here for Class Park. He was actually here because he's interested in Noam Dar's match. Mr. Samuel says that he can't book Dar to fight at high stakes. Rivers says, yeah, that's right, because I already got a match. The board of directors has informed him that since next episode is his historic 46th episode, he'll be defending his title against Ciampa and Gargano. Those two get to settle their rivalry in the ring, and Rivers gets a big-time match for the pay-per-view. He thanks Mr. Samuel for letting him stop by and scout out future competitors, and he says that he feels that Dar would be an excellent choice. Just keep that in mind. Following this, Miles Crossbones Jacobs, the North American champion, then comes out to have his match against the debuting Austin Zero. The new wrestler then comes down to the ring. We go to that now. Zero can even take off his shirt. Another theme song hits, and it is Andre Brooks. He's got a microphone in hand, and he has this to say. You think you can disrespect NXT, this company, the champion, and me? You walk in to take over, rip the spotlight off the new champion just to cut everybody in line. Do you have any awareness? Do you have any sense, Zero? You understand that there are consequences for your actions. You didn't sign to come to some indie promotion like ZWZ or CWF. You signed to the WWE. You disrespected the champion, and you disrespected the number one contender while I was unconscious. To me, that's a cardinal sin. You signed the dotted line to WWE, and you know what that means, Zero? You stepped into an ocean. You stepped forward. Be prepared to have someone else step up to you. You want to cut in line? You'll have to get through me. Because this match isn't happening tonight. If you beat me, you don't just get to fight Jacobs. I'll give you my number one contendership opportunity. That means I don't fight him. You'll earn it though. Because I'm not giving you a 10-minute timer. You either pin me for the 3 count, or I tap out. If you refuse this match, I'll put your head through a car window. Our GM will have his newest signing in the ER, and that will be the footprint you leave on Universe Mode before we go off the air. So what do you say, Zero? Still think you're the hero of your own story? Because I'm about to throw your career around before it can even get a chance to take off. Brooks slowly steps toward the ring, and Austin Zero motions for a microphone from the timekeeper, and once he gets it, is this thing on? Mighty fine words from a mighty contender and a former champion. I do understand, Brooks, that my actions have consequences. Whether it was against Jacobs or you, I rattled the cage. Think about it. I've got eyes on me. And now, you, tonight, both from fans and from management. I'm doing you a favor. I'm doing the North American title a favor. And I'm doing NXT a favor because I've got the whole world talking. But you know what? You know what, Brooks? I accept your offer. I'm not here to back down. I'm here to write a legacy. Leave a footprint. Like you said, you want to steal my words. And I want to ensure that Austin Zero is a name that's never forgotten. If going through you, Brooks, is what ensures that, then I'm ready to make myself immortal in the chronicles of Universe Mode history. And why wait, too? Hey, Jacobs, I know you don't speak because you got that, you know, protective guard over your jaw, but you can hit the showers. We can settle this next NXT. Rip that promotional, personal brand shirt of yours off, Andre Brooks. Yeah, the one with the NXT brand logo on it that says you're the Panther, the Tower of Pain, whatever. Set that mic down, walk up those steps, lace up those boots real tight, because I'm about to put both them up your rear end, and let's throw down. And he looks to the referee. You can contact our GM and see if he objects. If not, let's give the fans a match. And the match they do have, as it is Andre Brooks versus Austin Zero, number one contendership, right now. So here we go, ladies and gentlemen. A Titan, a Tower of Pain of NXT, waging war against Austin Zero, who is laying in the strikes in this now-turned number one contendership match. Oh, and a body slam there. The big man using his raw power early on to put down Zero on the back burner, on the defense. As Brooks lays in the punishment. Picking him up into a fireman's carry, dropping on the top turnbuckle now, just a boot to the face. The disrespect by the Panther on full display. As he taunts this crowd, he feels that he has been disrespected. And that, in my opinion, will get you nowhere. As he delivers a powerful clothesline, nearly decapitating Austin Zero. A wake-up call for the man who is making his in-ring debut on this episode. Says a knife-edge chop once. Blocked by Zero. Flips him over. Oh, and delivers a knee right to the jaw. Zero has turned the tide. A miracle, perhaps. Here in the Performance Center. Insecurity there. And Andre Brooks falls off the edge of the apron. As now Zero leaps over the ropes and wipes him out. A vaulting effort from Austin Zero. We're getting back inside the ring. Brooks now knows what it feels like to be on the defense once again. As he kicks out there. He was stunned, bamboozled, shocked. After losing the North American Championship at NXT TakeOver. And is willing to go through hell itself to get it back onto his shoulder. Even willing to put his number one contendership on the line if it means that Zero doesn't cut through the line. As there is a springboard body splash. For wrenching the neck further of Andre Brooks. Zero has taken the driver's seat, much to my surprise. And he is looking to take full advantage of that and win this match as he picks up Andre Brooks and delivers a brain buster one, but only gets a one count. But still, the power and strength of Zero should be commended here. In his debut, as he looks to the crowd, he's looking to fly through the sky. That stalling could make you crash and burn as Brooks caught him in the air. Body slam by the Titan of NXT. Turns him around. He's sending him through the roof before bringing it back down to earth. Cover to win the match. One and a half. Austin Zero found his senses and managed to kick out to stay alive. Whether by luck, fortitude, skill, or resilience, I don't know. But he has stayed alive here tonight. Zero fires back after being dumped out of the ring, bringing it back inside the ring. That could be dangerous. As Zero paces the ring, trying to hatch a bold plan as Brooks picks himself up. Looks to cross the ring. Zero makes a leap and catches Brooks with a knee in the chest. Bringing him down. Picking Brooks back up. Zero. Super kick to the face. Isn't enough to win the match. One. Two. Kick out at two, but he does get a near fall on the Tower of Pain. The Panther of NXT could be slain. Two NXT shows in a row. If he's not careful, let's look at this. What a German suplex out of the corner wall. No. What power. My zero. As he continues to impress. Look for the running knee to the face. Oh, a reverse clothesline after Brooks dodged it. Oh, oh, oh my gosh. There could be a concussion protocol being brought down after this match upon Zero if he's not careful. As Brooks, that exposed headbutts repeatedly, now follows it up with another one-handed slam into the canvas. Almost puts it through. One hand on the chest. One, two, kick out at two, but you can see Zero barely, weakly, got his shoulder up. Brooks looking to take him up to the top of the tower to drop him down. No! White Zero countered! Zero countered! Rolled him up! One! Oh no! One and almost a two. Zero bounces off the ropes for some momentum. Drops him down by the legs. Overhand strikes. Rolls through. Brooks is reeling. And now Zero with a stomps to the ligaments of Andre Brooks, stalking his prey, much to the Panther's dismay. As now, Zero looks to the crowd before looking back at his opponent, sizing him up, one-legged, code breaker, cover, one, two, kick out at two. I don't know what we're going to call that, but for now, I will call it the Zero Hour. As now he tosses him into the corner. Looking for another strike, but no. Brooks counters. Wait a second. We've seen this by Roadkiller. The bounce. The Panthers bounce. Connects on Zero to win the match. One, two, three now. By sheer will, Zero found the stars and saw the lights and managed to kick out in the nick of time. Cover again. One and a half. Zero is still in this match. And this crowd is on their feet. And so is he. As he dodges a clothesline attempt by Brooks. He caught him. Neck breaker there. Down goes Brooks. And up goes Zero as he takes to the skies. Delivers a perfect elbow off the top rope. Two. Kick out at two. Brooks once more kicks out, dodges Zero's fast-paced offense. And now Brooks Irish whips him out of the ring. And for a moment, the crowd can breathe with ease as Zero and Brooks have departed the ring. But Brooks picks him up into a power bomb. Oh, onto the edge of the apron. Slaps him into the LED board. As Zero is seeing stars in a power slam there. Or a scoop slam, excuse me. We're delivering a German suplex there. Wow. Wow. Ooh. Wow. Brooks has busted him open. There is color, and the color is red on the face of Zero as it is pouring down his face. It is not a good color, but he's going to wear it with pride, and he's going to have to show, or it's a scar from this war of attrition between the two of them, as Brooks now turns him over into a Boston Crab. Will Zero, the bloodied and battered Zero, tap out of the middle of the ring? No, he powers out of the Boston Crab, sizes up Brooks, rolls him up to win the match. Cover, one, two. Kick out at two. Zero to his feet. So does Brooks. And oh, wait. Rolling elbow right there. Should I say a discus elbow as Brooks rolls out of the ring. Zero sizing him up. Takes to the skies. No, he's too far away. Brooks. Fox watches him sail by and picks him up. Now, to bring him back inside the ring. No! Slams his face on the gas wound, trying to draw more color. And when I mean color, I mean blood. The terminology of wrestling. For those who don't know, as Zero's wound looks worse, but he's gonna power through it. Oh! A crossbody goes wrong. It goes awry, but still gets the result that he was looking for. And Zero uses the ropes. Leg drop there. Reverse leg drop off the bottom rope. And now, sizing up Brooks, he's got him in prime time position to do a springboard off the ropes. No! Brooks sidesteps. Zero, his knee buckled slightly. Brooks is going to take advantage of the situation. He turns him around. Ladies and gentlemen, get on your feet, because here comes NXT's Panthers Pounce. Connecting on Austin Zero, Brooks, to remain number one contender. 2, 3, Andre Brooks says get back in line. Because there is only one contender for that title, and it's me. But a hell of a battle, a hell of a war, a hell of a confrontation. Zero didn't back down. He accepted that match. Whether you think he's foolish for doing so, he accepted the match and put up a battle against Andre Brooks in his debut. Though he came up short, I have no doubt that this is just the beginning for Austin Zero. And for Andre Brooks, it is the road to redemption that he continues to go down in his quest to become champion once again. Quick to lose it, but hopefully in his mind, quick to regain what he has lost. So ladies and gentlemen, Andre Brooks stands tall here in matchup number 3. More to come, but for now, Brooks stands tall. The Tower of Pain claims another victim here tonight on NXT. After the match, Andre Brooks lifts up Zero and puts him in the corner before telling Zero to stay out of his way. Zero, in a daze, replies, "How about you stay out of mine, big man? I'm not here to finish second place to anyone." Brooks slaps Zero across the face. Zero is stunned for a few seconds before asking, "Is that all you got?" Brooks rears back to delay in some more offense, but security dive into the ring and separate him. Mr. Samba comes out and tells Brooks to head to the back. He's won and will face Jacobs next NXT. He then orders security to take Zero to the training room and then after that, to his office for a little bit of a chat. Well, there we go. Following this, Blaze, Veronica Blaze, and Dakota Kai both do individual promos hyping themselves up for their match tonight. Blaze states that facing the most decorated women's champion is the best opportunity to establish her superiority and claim to be the number one contender. Dakota Kai, on the other hand, is saying that this new challenger is a test for her to prove that she can still remain on top of the women's division, even though times have changed. Either way, then cuts to a vehicle arriving to the arena and out steps the Bella Twins. Really? They're returning. They head to the ring. Once in the ring, Nikki Bella states that she and her sister are back because of a lot of buzz around a woman's talent. There are constant tweets that came up on their feed about a woman who they feel is overhyped, overrated, and time to be excommunicated from NXT. She's talking about Demi Dynamite. She knows Dynamite is taking some time off tonight, but wanted to make an official challenge to the newbie. Oh, isn't that nice? This challenge isn't about respect or earning her place. Nikki wants to use Dynamite's hype to launch back into the spotlight. Ah, there it is. Where she and her sister belong, to be in the running for the women's title again. This challenge is to also humble Dynamite. She's beaten a few former champions, but they were all nothing compared to Nikki Bella. The twins look forward to hearing from her next NXT. The only explosion that will go off is Dynamite's career going up in smoke by the hands of Nikki Bella. Oh! Clever. Very witty. Sorry, my sarcasm came through while reading my own script. Either way, ladies and gentlemen, it is the number one contendership between Veronica Blaze and Dakota Kai, and after an incredible match between the two of them, Veronica Blaze picks up the win. She gets on the mic and says after the match that Alice York, the champion, is living her happiest moment right now. She's married and on her honeymoon. Congrats. However, when she comes back to NXT next show, she'll be face to face with reality, a challenger who wants to desperately be the champion. She's just bested the most successful women's champion of all time. Now, she looks to take down York and drag her down from her happiest moment to her lowest. At NXT TakeOver 59, York will be married but won't be the champion anymore. Blaze is on fire, and York won't stop this woman from achieving her lifelong dream. A determined challenger against a newly crowned champion. Then cuts to Mr. Samuel's office, where he announces to the audience that next NXT, there will be a fatal five-way match to determine the number one contender for the NXT title. Not at NXT TakeOver, but this is for afterwards. Barnett will face the champion at TakeOver 59. This match will have participants including TJ Ballman, Tony Ramirez, David Perez, Noam Dar, and someone else who he just got off the phone with. The camera pans away to reveal Zero was in the room and a pack, an ice pack, is on his face. Mr. Samuel and Zero proceed to have this promo. Not fully scripted out, but the details are here. Zero proceeds to throw the pack aside and explain that it's not about proving to anybody else that he deserves to hang. He knows he's ready. It's also taught at the Performance Center to bet on yourself and go beyond what you think is what you're capable of. If he settles for anything less, he's not succeeding. He's only got one shot, this brief moment to make an impact. And he'll do whatever it takes. That means facing Brooks, the Margrave, competing in the Royal Rumble, or fighting any champion, whether from the main roster or not. He will do anything to immortalize himself in the history books. Mr. Samuel explains back that it doesn't mean you piss off a man who's quite capable of putting him on the shelf before he can get going. Making a name takes time. Pushing yourself is a method of motivation. Not to go to a point where you're risking serious injury. He's got his debut over with. Go to the locker room. Take a shower. Get dressed and take the day off tomorrow. Rest and recover. After that, back to the Performance Center for more training. Zero looks down and agrees before thanking him for the opportunity. Just as he's about to leave, he looks over his shoulder and asks, just out of curiosity, who do you have listed from our roster to enter the Royal Rumble? Mr. Samuel only replies, you'll also be evaluated by a doctor tomorrow if you open your mouth again, Zero. He keeps his mouth closed and the segment ends. Very well. Well, if that wasn't straight to the point, I don't know what is. After this, the show cuts to the locker room where Wilkens is getting warmed up for his match, the main event. He's approached by Kyle Jordan, Jackson Wolfe, and Jacob Knox. Jordan asks why Wilkens has this problem. Why does he insist on causing problems? Wilkens says that the faction is called Redemption. He's not here to redeem his mean streak, but to redeem everyone's perception of not taking him seriously. He's a threat. As for his issues with York and Walker joining, they're not true members of the faction. Regardless of what Jordan says, they aren't real members. If Jordan is just going to add members and pass around his own teammates to help him win championship gold, then maybe it's time for Wilkens to fight for what he wants. That's to be the best. Deep down, Jordan is afraid that Wilkens is just better than him. That fear is accurate. He knows it. Wilkens will prove that tonight by becoming something Jordan never hoped to achieve. NXT Championship Gold. He walks out and leaves, and the rest of the faction look troubled and bothered as he heads out. So now, ladies and gentlemen, we head to the main event tonight. Arthur Rex defending his NXT Championship against Jackson Wilkens. Next. So main event time, the challenger still wearing the redemption colors versus the new NXT champion, Arthur Rex, who delivers a high knee, leveling the challenger. Rex has this chip on his shoulder to prove that he is, without a doubt, the NXT champion, as he's got a leg lock around the head. Jackson Wilkens, who works his way out of it, off of the champion, back elbow there, Wilkens. Irish whipping him into the corner. Stinger splash. Missed it there. Arthur Rex sidesteps. But Wilkens rolls him through. Dropkick attempt. No. Rex sidestep delivered. A German suplex. One. No. Count of one. Rex, though, sending a message early on as he delivers a... Oh! An adaptation of the crossroads cover to put him away. No. Kick out of one. Now, Wilkens turns the tide and takes control of the match. Rolls him over for a cover to put him away. Whoa! No, what a half. Rex popping right back up against rolled up here. Cover! No! Kick out there. Rex stays alive. Especially after the roll up. He had a well scout. Bats there and away. Sizes up. The challenger delivers a suplex there. Rex, the champion, takes back control and delivers a knee to the face. And a second knee. Dead insult to injury. As Arthur Rex, the British brawler, goes for a... What a Phoenix splash to a standing. Jackson Wilkens off the middle rope, an incredible display of athleticism. For locking in a submission, the rings of Saturn, trapping, twisting, and contorting. Wilkens, only for him to stay alive, fight out of it, backs off. Arthur Rex delivers a twirl, a whirl, Hearn can run him. Dropping him down, Rex rolls underneath the bottom rope to try and create some distance. Wilkens sends him to the outside, and for the moment, the fans can breathe a sigh of relief in terms of decision. However, Wilkens is perched high above. He's gonna dive at full sail. No! Wiped out, Arthur Rex. So now he picks him up. Perfect timing, I swear. The Irish whips him inside the ring. My apologies for the data being a bit corrupted as he bounces off the ropes. Delivers the axe kick. Way now. Rex caught the leg. Drops him down. And now Rex perched up on the middle turnbuckle. Here we go. Takes a leap. Barely connects with it. A miracle, perhaps, that had landed. Now he sizes up. Jackson Wilkens and delivers a blockbuster out of the corner. Two. No. Kick out at two. So close yet so far. As this match is not over. Rex turns it into a cross face as he cinches it in. Locks it in on Wilkens, who can tap out right here in the middle of the ring. Will he quit? Will he submit? Is it over? No. Wilkens stays alive, shot to the face. Backs off Rex there. Rex with a series of forearms, rocking him backwards. And now these two back and forth, to and fro, exchanging blows. And now Rex missed it. Clothesline delivered by Wilkens. Wilkens is on fire now. Picks him up. Turns him inside out with a DDT. Now Wilkens shoots him off the ropes and delivers a super kick there. As now Wilkens takes the driver's seat, drops down Rex. So the ropes in a falling headbutt. This match picked up the pace and then slowed back down. In the favor of Jackson Wilkens as he twists the knee of Arthur Rex. Rex writhing in pain. You can hear him scream. But either way, Wilkens is going to press on the offense. Oh, no. Rex delivered an elbow right to the skull. Looks for the high knee, but no. Wade Wilkens turns it around with a twirl of wire hurt and runner right there. It's Arthur Rex picking up Rex now. Wilkens got him in the triangle armbar, trying to force Rex to quit. Will half of the Ambassadors of Violence tap out? Will the British Brawler quit? No. No. He wills himself out of it and delivers a powerful strike combination, rocking Wilkens. Wilkens ducks it, delivers a clothesline there. And now, Wilkens, ladies and gentlemen, sizing him up for the end. Will he get him? Inverted crush, covered to become NXT champion two. Kick out at two, Arthur Rex stays alive. Wow. Now Wilkens targets Rex there. For now, cinching in a submission that could force the champion once more to quit. Rex powering through the pain. He wheels himself out of it. Flips Jackson Wilkens right over his head. The power of the champion on full display as he locks him right back into another crossface. Second time this match, trying to make him quit, trying to make him tap. These two men utilizing submissions to try and gas each other out. So Wilkens works his way to his feet once more as Arthur Rex well scouted one more time, delivering that clothesline counter. Cover using the ropes to his advantage. One. No. Kick out of one and a half. The frustration on full display. Knee right to the ribs. Leg drop right there by Arthur Rex. It's now Rex. Ooh, drops down Wilkens. Pressing the knee right to the back of the skull. Or Wilkens, in a daze, getting to his feet. Rex, no, batted away. Oh, Rex dodged him and now delivers a Luther's press to Jackson Wilkens. We're picking him up. Delivers those knee strike combinations before delivering a German suplex again. One, two, kick out at two. So close speed yet so far. Rex picks him up. Irish whips him into the corner yet again. High knee connects. Brings him into the middle of the ring. And a crossroads is delivered to the doorstep of Wilkens' face. As now Rex with a cover to retain. One, two, kick out at two. Oh, a knee to the, or an elbow to the face by Wilkens. Is it backed up Rex? I thought he had him, but instead he tags him with the axe kick. Is that enough? As Wilkens with a cover to become NXT champion. No. Arthur Rex once more kicks out and stays alive. His title reign hangs in the balance as it could come to an end as he looks for the inverted crush. Now hip toss there by Arthur Rex. He's sizing him up to put away Jackson Wilkens. Blockbuster out of the corner. One, two, no. Wilkens kicks out after the second blockbuster. Arthur Rex isn't done. Concocting a plan of mass destruction. Here it comes. Clothesline to hell. cover to retain. 1, 2, 3. The British brawler, Arthur Rex, is still the NXT champion of the world. He will have a monumental task ahead of him. Leon Barnett at NXT TakeOver. We still have a little bit of ways, but that is the man in sight as he has bested Jackson Wilkens. A monumental first step in his reign. A test of fortitude, perseverance, and willpower by the new champion. Can he maintain this success is the question. We'll have to find out. But for now, the champion is still the man who holds the gold and the top prize of NXT. So that closes out the main event. We have one more segment, then the closing of the show. Arthur Rex. Still the champ. After the match, Rex retains and lifts up his title. Just then, the lights go out. Static appears in the Titantron, and then someone picks up a camera from this perspective. It focuses on a hooded figure who asks if Ryan was afraid. It was the Margrave. Well, guess again. The man yanks off the hood to reveal himself as Chris Hall. He says that he's far more terrifying than the Margrave or a primetime Colt Lee. He was watching and heard everybody talk about lines and order. Hall takes priority. He qualifies for high stakes, and everyone assumes he's gone from NXT. Just because he makes a few appearances on Raw and it seems like he's pissing off coldly. Nah. He's not done with NXT yet. Rex said his victory felt tainted. Well, he agrees. Because next NXT, Chris Hall gets his match. And Rex has a shot to get that chip off his shoulder. Chris Hall and Arthur Rex for the NXT title. Hall laughs and says when he gets that title back, he'll win the Royal Rumble and headline WrestleMania, where he'll become NXT champion and world champion. After that, he'll become immortalized. The feed ends and the screen had static, but for a flash, the Margrave's face could be seen before the show fades to black. So that will do it for NXT, ladies and gentlemen. It is episode 39, wrapped up into a bow, cinched, sealed, and ready to be gift-wrapped and opened this Christmas season. Ladies and gentlemen, we are one episode away now from high stakes. I'll try and do it live sometime over the course of the next week. We'll try and get some content out. We'll try and get some stuff done before the holiday season. I thank you all for your patience with me. It has been constantly like a snail's pace progress, like chipping away at an ice block, trying to get this video done. And I'm glad to be finished to then provide it all for you. I hope you all enjoyed the video. Leave a like, subscribe to the channel, of course, if you choose Matt Army. But most importantly, as always, suit up Matt Army, because I will see you all at high stakes. But for now, NXT has come to a close.